Your MacDon combine header has an active mechanical float system that allows your header to move independently of the combine and react instantly to changing ground conditions. Proper float settings are essential to ensuring you get the maximum performance out of your header. It is recommended that the float is checked and adjusted at the start of each season and anytime the header does not appear to be following the ground correctly. A header set too heavy may wear out components prematurely and cause poor performance along the cutter bar in wet conditions. A header set too light may skip and leave crop uncut. All options and accessories, such as cross auger or stabilizer wheels, must be installed on the header before setting float. If you add additional kits, you will need to repeat the float setting procedure. To start, ensure that the float locks are disengaged on both sides of the header. If you have a flex draper, lock the wings into rigid mode by moving both wing locking levers to the locked position. The header is in rigid mode when the wing locking mechanisms move into the top slot. If the lock link does not engage, move the wing by raising and lowering the header, either by hand or with the combine. Prior to setting header float, you must also lift the gauge wheels to the top storage position. Park the combine and the header on level ground. Raise the cutter bar 6 to 10 inches above the ground. Level your combine feeder house faceplate. Tilt your header to position B1/2 on the indicator. Move your reel down and above the cutter bar at position 5 on the right-hand reel arm. Remove the torque wrench from its storage position. Position the wrench on the float check located at the base of the adapter. Apply smooth, steady pressure on the torque wrench, causing the header to move. Continue pushing down on the torque wrench with the same slow, steady motion until the wrench's indicator reaches a maximum reading and begins to decrease. Note the maximum reading. The proper wrench reading will vary depending on your header and ground conditions. In general terms, float should be lighter in wet conditions and heavier in uneven or hilly conditions. Compare your wrench reading with the table located in your header operator's manual or the quick card. As a starting point for general cutting, we recommend setting the float to 2 on the wrench. Optimal float settings for your header might vary depending upon harvest conditions and your header configuration. If adjustments are required, remove the spring bolt locks and reinstall after adjustments are completed. If the wrench reading is too high, meaning the float is too heavy, then apply more attention to the float springs by turning the float springs clockwise. Turn each spring by the same amount. If the wrench reading is too low, meaning the float is too light, decrease the spring tension by turning the float springs counterclockwise. Now repeat this procedure for the opposite side of the header. When finished, return to the right-hand side of the header to recheck the float reading in case it changed with adjustments to the left-hand side. For 45 and 40-foot double knife headers, adjust your float as described, then loosen off your right-hand side float springs by 2 turns counterclockwise. This compensates for center of gravity changes due to the extra knife drive. Your header is now set to factory recommended float settings. These settings are simply a good starting point. If your header seems to require additional adjustment, then please consult your operator's manual, contact your nearest MacDon dealer, or contact MacDon directly for further assistance.